Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Trevor back with more blood. Fresh supply. Last time, we fought through the cold rush, and now we have descended into the bowels of the earth. So let's go. Mind your step here. We have a mini earthquake that splits the ground open like this, and you can see down there is a big old lava pit. And we don't want to fall into that, so let's just drop onto the lip of that platform. Nice, and we'll get rid of all those guys. Anybody gonna come back up? Nope, alright. So let's switch to the remote detonators. I'm gonna get Beast Vision ready for this next part. Because when we run down here, we get trapped in the mine. And oh no, zombies, oh god, and there's a ton of them, man. There's so many. Oof, let's get past, Turn on Beast Vision, that way we can see them all. And just blow them up. Oh. Just as long as you're not close to your own bombs. And this guy, alright. So now that the majority of them are dead, we'll cut off Beast Vision. And there's two ways to get back out to the main area. The first is back to the beginning of the level. Well, close to it at least. Back to where we dropped off here. And the other, yeah, we'll grab that in a minute. The other is off to the right here. And yeah, sometimes you'll have stragglers that show up in these spots here, but most of the time, if you get them all with the bombs there, and make sure you get out of the way, then yeah, they'll all go down. Now, we'll go ahead and activate this cart and send it that way. And while that's moving, we'll grab this. Guns akimbo. And we'll run down here, because we've got a bunch of fanatics. First on that side. And then on that side. Alright, so that's the end of all of them. And let's hide in the cart here. Let's be stealthy. Let's be cool and quiet here. Because we're gonna have cultists. Whoop. And then the wall lowers. Jumps out of the way for us here, or moves out of the way. And where's that other gargoyle? Where'd you go? Whoop. Come on. Uh-oh. There we go. All right. I'm going to go ahead and use that portable med kit there. Now, with some dynamite here, there's a bunch of spiders over there off to the right that I want to take out with a few bundles here. Usually about three or four will get rid of most of them. And jump all the way across. Get rid of that guy. Any remaining spiders, get rid of them. Secret back here with a life seed and some shells. This is a pretty cool, I really like this secret for some reason. It's just kind of like back here in this abandoned area. But it's easy, you can easily access it, you just walk right through there. But anyhow, let's grab this, yeah. Light them up! Fry them, cook them up, yeah, burn them. And that should be enough for that guy, yep. Alright, so let's head over here. Now, I didn't get... Oh, okay, at least he burned. I was like, I didn't get any of them? Now let's jump back. Get rid of... Oh, jeez. Go away. There we go. Whoop. Okay. Jump on back. There we go. Ugh. Yeah, usually I can get both of them there. Or at least I can get one of them. That's the goal, is to at least get one with the napalm launcher. Now, that... Yeah, like that. Oh, nice. Yeah, we'll just take the last one out with the shoddy there. And we're gonna have bloated butchers again. Ooh, nice. That guy. Oh, come on. There we go. He's all dead. So we'll go up here next, and we're gonna have some choking hands that are gonna try and swallow our soul, but we're not gonna let that happen, of course. There we go. Alright, spray can there. Another napalm launcher. This is a great... This is the penultimate level of the episode, but it's just... what a great penultimate level for the episode here. Just... I don't know, man. I really love this level. Just incredible design here. Let's get rid of that guy. Now, where'd that gargoyle go? Oh, he's up there. Whoop! Where did he go? Ah, screw it. Let's go. Oh, I just heard him. This guy. Get rid of him. Yeah. Just blow them all to smithereens there. Yeah, zombie head on fire. So, next stop. We are not going to go across the bridge. Instead, we're going to jump down. Get out of here. There we go. Grab the proximity detonators if you want them. You don't have to grab them. We haven't really used them a whole lot. And yes, you can lower this down. It'll take you up there. But we're not going to go down there. Instead, where we want to go, if we hit the jump boots and fall down, we won't take any damage. Now, let's do that there. Get rid of that phantasm. All right, we've got some, we've got some life essences here. And the radio. Yeah, well, looks like we're not getting any signal on the other end there. So anyway, let's go ahead, flip that lever, which activates a conveyor belt, and the way we get out of here, we can grab the super armor, lower down the elevator here, and flip this again. And this is actually pretty cool right here. We have a crack in the wall, right? And they're so nice, they let you get out of here by giving you TNT. So we'll go ahead and use... Yeah, we'll go ahead and blow up the wall and get right back out to where we were before. Right out here. Now, let's jump up and across the bridge. Now, right here, there's kind of an interesting little spot here, and I want to show off something here. So, naturally, of course, if you get crushed, you'd think if you'd get crushed by one of these crushers, you would die. Well... I did die there, but not when it crushed me. The point I'm trying to make here is that this area is kind of wonky. It's as if you die by simply touching the ceiling right there, not getting squished by the compressors here. Yeah, because see, that thing, you know, we're fine. You know, these things are smushing us, but they're not doing any damage. But anyhow, let's grab the jump boots. Now, you can flip this lever here. And it'll actually move those bloody hooks down the line there. But what I'm going to do is jump up here with the boots. Oh, there's no guys up here. Sometimes there's some... Usually there's like a cultist and a fanatic up here. But what I'm going to do is flip this lever instead, which lowers down this wall and sends that rock way up there. And we're going to... Yeah, they give you jump boots to let you come up here. But this is how you proceed. And see, this lever does the same thing as the other one does. It moves the hooks on down the line there. But anyway, we're just going to jump on off. Get down here. Now, here's the bridge that we were at before, where we took out all the fanatics with the guns akimbo. See, you can actually jump from down there to up here and skip a big portion of the level. But, of course, doing that, you miss secrets. So, that's why we didn't do it. Alright, blow that up. Oh, actually, we'll keep the dynamite out. Ooh, what was that noise behind us? That didn't sound good. Glad we got through there when we did. At least we can go back, but still. Anyhow. Cultist. We'll use the flare. Whoop! Make sure you nab that guy in the back before he jumps in the water there. Because if he gets in the water, he can be annoying to deal with. But anyhow, that's all the guys here. So now we ourselves will go into the water. Kind of lure these guys around. I'm going to try something different here. Come on, fellas. Yeah! Oh, I didn't even get them all! What the heck? Cool. Well, let's go ahead and grab some air here and drop back down in. Now... Aha! Here we go. This is the side I wanted to end up on, because this takes us to a secret up in here with another diving suit. And that way we won't have to worry about running out of air in our old one. We got another gill beast here. Alright. Hit the... move the wooden bar there. And that allows us to proceed yet again through here. Through the depths here. The shadowy dark depths. Yeah, I mean, look at this. Is just... I don't know, man. I mean, it's like I've been saying before. Episode 2 is just so good. Oh, got one of them. Oh, wow. There we go. Okay, and so yeah, we get rid of all those zombies. There are gargoyles up there, and they might see you up there, but we'll deal with them later at a more opportune time, we shall say. So as soon as we go up here, get ready, because we're going to have cultists. Yeah, send that guy flying, get him. Now you can try to nab those gargoyles out there with the napalm launcher, but I'm going to go for the voodoo doll here until one of them flies down to try and get me. Now, I don't know why I'm not hitting this one. He's way out in the open. Yeah, but they're just going to fly in circles and not really... Okay, cool, we got him. They're just going to fly in circles and not really do anything. Sometimes, if they get out of control, they'll fall in the water and die, but that doesn't always happen, so watch out. Now, right here... Whoa, jump back! Oh, what the heck? Oh! Where are you going? There we go. Come on! Go down! There we go. All right. They're all dead. Jump across again. Yeah. Ooh! Took them out nice and quick. I just love to see it. Absolutely love to see it. So let's go up the elevator. Now, for here... This is kind of a mean trap, I think. But it's blood, so of course it has to be mean. We get these gargoyles here, right? And remember the strategy. If you need to crouch to not take any damage, if you need a minute just to breathe here, then you can absolutely do that. Unless, well, no, yeah, it's not. Yeah, they can't hit you. So, whoa, they can if you stand back up though. All right, so that's the end of them. Now with the napalm launcher, ready to see something fun? Watch this. Oh, lovely, lovely, look at that. Oh yeah, just made mincemeat out of all of them, and we got a bunch of yummy power-ups there. We're going to move on through the tunnel here. And I think I got one of them. Actually, let's go ahead and fire at the crack in the wall down there. Now that guy, he'll probably go sinking into the water there. Whoop! Get him? Cool. Sounds like they all burned in there. So let's jump across. Get some armor. Now, oh, there he is. From here we can nab him with the voodoo doll. Yeah, there we go. All right. Yes, no one is safe from Caleb and... Oh, goodness. No, I knew those things were there. I just like to play the part, though, of going like, oh. But anyhow, yeah, they will drop from wherever. I'm not, like, the ceiling, I guess. And then when we get out to here, we have all this ammo here. We have a voodoo doll, which we'll save. But let's go ahead and let's use this. Get rid of all the spiders. Again, save the voodoo doll. We have a spider door here, so we'll open it up. Go on in. We got the candles. And if we make our way down, we have to lower that stone pillar to exit, but don't get too comfortable. We got another stone gargoyle. This is the third one of the episode. Fourth we've seen in total, and he's... Whoa, let's not be near him when he goes to do that. All right, I think I'll... Whoa. Let's see. Yeah, I don't want to just use the voodoo doll on him here. I actually want to, you know, get into a little bit of a fight here. We'll go ahead and collect that. We'll go down to 45 balls of napalm here. Will you stand still? Freaking... Yeah, there we go. Let's go ahead and grab this thing here. Get crouched on the ground here. Get ready to use our voodoo power here against him. It's interesting, regular stone gargoyles, if you remember back to episode 1, with as tough as Chio was, with how much HP he has over 6,000 HP on the well-done difficulty. The normal stone gargoyles that you see in all other episodes following episode 1 have even more HP than that. I think it's somewhere around, like, over 500 hit points more than Chiyo, as tough as he was in episode one. But anyhow, now that he's dead, we can proceed. So let's lower the pillar on down. And the wall shall open up here to reveal another secret passageway. So we'll go on down, and here's our exit. Yeah, nothing around the pillar here. So when you're ready, let's go. Yeah, and it's just gonna keep telling us that we cheated for the remainder of the episode here. But that doesn't matter. What matters is that we have made it to the lair of Sheol.
Hey, she-bitch, let's go.
So that's what we'll be tackling next time. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.